हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल AMIE ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अ न्यूमेरिकल दैट हैज बीन आस्क्ड इन समर 2005। दिस न्यूमेरिकल इज रिलेटेड टू थिन सिलेंडर। सो हियर इज द न्यूमेरिकल। The numerical is a cylindrical pressure vessel is fabricated from steel plate and has a thickness of 20 mm. The thickness is given. Thickness is 20 mm. The inner diameter of the vessel is 450 mm. Inner diameter is also given and its length is 2 meter. Length is also given. Determine the maximum internal pressure that can be applied if the longitudinal stress is limited is 140 MPa and the circumferential stress is limited to 60 MPa. It should be to not is limited to 140 MPa. So what are the data given? So given data is, let's resolve this problem. How to solve? Solution. So given data are given. What are the data are given? Thickness of 20 mm. Thickness is 20 mm. Inner diameter of the vessel is 450 mm. D is given 450 mm, correct, and its length is 2 meter. So it has be, it is to be converted into mm, millimeter. So 2000 mm, millimeter, correct. Now determine the maximum internal pressure. We have to calculate the value of P, that is internal pressure, correct, that can be applied if the longitudinal stress is limited to 140 MPa. So longitudinal stress is given, that is sigma L 140 MPa, correct, and the circumferential stress is limited to 60 MPa. Sigma C is 60 MPa, correct. So here sigma L is given, that is sigma L is 140 MPa. So we have to convert it into Newton per mm square, correct, because all the parameters like T, D, L are given in millimeter. So we can convert it into millimeter, Newton per square mm. How can we convert it? We know that this is 140 MPa and 1 megapascal is, that is 10, 1 mega pascal is mega. If we want to convert the mega pascal into Newton per mm square, then we have to multiply by 10 to the power 6, that is Newton per meter square, correct. So 1 mega pascal equal to 10 to the power 6 Newton per meter square. Now 140 into 10 to the power 6 into, if we want to convert the meter square into millimeter square, then we have to multiply it by how much? 10 to the power minus 6, correct? This is Newton per mm square, and this plus and minus is cancelled. So 140 megapascal is equal to Newton per mm square. How we have converted? You know, this is basic process to convert the megapascal into Newton per mm square. Now sigma c is also given, that is 60 MPa circumferential stress, that is given here. This is 60 MPa. So directly we can write 60 MPa is equal to 60 Newton per mm square, correct? Now we know that circumferential stress sigma c is equal to Pd by 2t. Now the sigma c is given, that is 60 is equal to P into, dia is also given, that is 450 divided by 2 into, thickness is also given, that is 20 mm, correct? So this 0 and 0 will be cancelled, 0, 0 is cancelled. So 45 P by 4. Now 45 P is equal to 4 into 60, or P is equal to 4 into 60 by 45. So 3 15 is 45, 4 15 is 60, 16 by 3. If I divide at this, then we will get the value of 16 by 3, that is how much? 16 by 3 is equal to 5.33. So we got the value of internal pressure when the circumferential stress will be 60. This is 5.33 Newton per mm square, because so this will be, so the value of P is equal to 5.33 Newton per mm square, correct? This is one of the value of internal pressure. But when the longitudinal stress is also given here, what is the value of longitudinal stress? That is, this is longitudinal stress, that is 140 Newton square mm, correct? So we know that longitudinal stress sigma L equal to Pd by 4t. So what is the value of that? We have to calculate P. Dia is given, diameter is 450 mm, divided by 4 into thickness is also given, that is 20. So this 0 and 0 will be cancelled, 0, 0 cancelled, 45 P by 8, correct? Now this is also given, which one? Longitudinal stress, that is 140, correct, equal to 45 P by 8, or P is equal to 140 into 8 by 45, correct. If we calculate 140 into 8 by 45 is equal to 24.88. This is 24.88 Newton per mm square, correct. So we got the value of P here also, that is P is equal to 24.88 Newton per mm square, correct. So we got the value of internal pressure that has to be calculated over here in this numerical question. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching my video. I will bring such a new videos, numerical, theoretical, each and every question of each and every question related to AMI section B for mechanics of solids. So please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that you will get direct notification of the videos whenever I upload on YouTube. And I hope these videos will be fruitful for you for the AMI section B examination for the subject of mechanics of solids. Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you for watching my video.